That was fun, man. Thank you. I want to send that back out to Glenn, man. You know, Glenn is suffering really, really seriously from Alzheimer's and dementia, and my grandmother too. So we're going to send that out to them, and I had to say that after the song so I could make it through it. But anyway, man, let's see here. I didn't write this one either, but I felt like getting funky. You got to go down to Louisiana and get funky. Here's some Jerry Reed for you. Now, Amos Roses was a Cajun. He lived by himself in the swamp. Hunted alligator for living. He just knocked him in the head with a stump. The Louisiana law gonna get you, ain't it? It ain't legal on an alligator down in the swamp, boy. Well, everyone blamed his old man for making him mean as a snake. When Amos Moses was a boy, his daddy would use him for alligator bait. Tie a rope around his face, throw him in the swamp. Alligator bait in a Louisiana bayou. About 45 miles southeast of Dippido, Louisiana. A man named Dyke Bill Sapp and his pretty wife, Anna. Raise up a son, could eat up his wedding groceries. Named him after a man in the cloth, called him Amos Moses. Well, the folks around South Louisiana said Amos was a hell of a man. He could trap the biggest, the meanest alligator, and just use one hand. That's all he got left, cause the alligator bit it. Left arm gone, feet up to the elbow. Sheriff caught wind that Amos was in the swamp planting alligator skin. So he snuck in the swamp, gonna get the boy, but he never come out again. Well, I wonder where the Louisiana sheriff went to. You can sure get lost in the Louisiana bayou. About 45 minutes southeast of Dippido, Louisiana. And a man named Doc Phil Sapp and his pretty wife Hannah. Well, they raised up a son, could eat up his weight in groceries. Named him after a man of the cloth, called him Amos Moses. Holy crap. By the end of that.